When mistakes occur, clinicians routinely recover from them. But rather than determining that that's just the way things are, we need to learn from situations when things go wrong. We need to learn from our defects. A very practical way to learn from defects is by asking four simple questions. What happened? Why did it happen? That is, what systems were involved? What did you do to reduce risk using those principles of safe design? And how do you know that it worked? That is, how do you know you actually reduced risk? We have many examples of how routines were changed when units learned from their mistakes and made changes to the system, reducing the risk that patients will be harmed.
In this unit, we have ongoing improvement work that happens here in the WICU by asking the nurses how they think the next patient's going to be harmed and what we can do to prevent that harm from happening. But I'm going to give you an example of a time when we didn't see how the next patient was going to be harmed. So there was a nurse who brought in his medications, antibiotic and a vasopressor, that were in similar IV bags. He then went to do something to his patient, and he came back to grab his antibiotic. He spiked it, he hung it, and he went about taking care of his patient. He then noticed that his patient's blood pressure was going way up. He tried to figure out immediately what had happened, and as he was retracing his steps, he realized that he had grabbed the wrong medication. He grabbed the vasopressor and hung it on straight tubing and was infusing it at a very fast rate. He immediately stopped it, called for help, and the patient recovered. When we sat down as a team to debrief after that event happened, what we came up with was, when we have two IV bags that look the same, we decided to make it look different somehow. And we put these orange labels on every vasopressor that arrived on the unit. So when it came up from the pharmacy, we would put this orange sticker on it. It was bright, it was a statement. And then if you brought that drug into your room, it would look different than any other drug that was there.
Now, some of you may think that these three principles are an oversimplification of a very complex science. And in part, you're right. But trust me, doing these three simple things, standardizing work whenever you can, creating independent checks for things that are important, and learning, not just recovering, when things go wrong, will dramatically help improve patient safety in your work area.